All right, it is time for our veterinary segment here. And many of the illnesses that we get, our pets can get them too. It just shows symptoms a little differently. One of the things is hypothyroidism in dogs. Good morning to Dr. Tamisha Hubbard and Dr. Jerome Williams.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Both of you. So, and who do we have here? Mrs. Nino.
This is Nino.
Hey, buddy.
Say
so
hi.
Pretty. All right, so hypothyroidism in animals, in dogs
yes.
in particular?
So, like you said, there are a lot of diseases that pets can get that are similar to human diseases, and hypothyroidism is one of those things. So it's a disease process where the thyroid gland that's located in the neck of animals doesn't produce enough thyroid hormone. Mm-hmm. And so it tends to result in some skin problems. Some pets will gain weight.
Mm-hmm. Just like people.
Correct.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So it affects their metabolism. So the metabolism slows down, so the pets are less active, they tend to gain weight, and sometimes it will result in hair loss and some skin diseases.
So how are they treated?
So usually we treat them with a thyroid supplement. Mm-hmm. So we replace the thyroid hormone with a pill that the owner has to give them on a daily basis. And most of the time, this is a lifelong therapy that these patients have to go on.
Now, Dr. Williams, is this something that you will see a pet come in and you'll see these symptoms and wonder if that's what it is?
Yes, sometimes the symptoms are so vague that I'm not able in my office to determine that's what it is. So mm-hmm. I have to send to a specialist, a dermatologist like Dr. Hubbard. But in many cases, you can see a dog and say, that may be a thyroid issue.
Is it easy to treat it once you start giving the pill?
It's usually pretty easy to treat. I mean, with the pill is really inexpensive, and the owners just come in and purchase it usually mm-hmm. once a month or every 2 months.
Is it a lifelong thing, or does it correct itself?
It's a lifelong thing
okay, so it's
once
not
we
gonna
diagnose
change.
It. Most of the time, it's not going to change at all. But we notice it in middle to older aged animals.
Okay.
So if we see those signs and symptoms, then that's something that we want to rule out. So we pretty much diagnose it with blood work.
And I would imagine it gives relief to the pet once
it
they
does.
Start that medication.
It does. So within 2 weeks or so of giving the medication, you'll start to see the pet's energy level
Aww.
Increase. Then they start to lose weight. And it takes a little bit longer for the skin problems to resolve. But some of them get reoccurring bacterial or yeast mm-hmm. infections on their skin. So we may have to treat those in the beginning.
All right. So if your pet's been gaining weight or you're seeing some issues, you might want to have that checked, right?
Yes, absolutely. And thyroid can be sort of a insidious condition that mm-hmm. we are misdiagnosing, calling it other things when we're seeing other conditions in the pet.
All right, right. Dr. Williams, Dr. Hubbard, good to see you.
All right.
See you, Nino. Nino's perfect, just sitting there. All right, now here's Mike.
All right.